Addressing the media during the weekly security briefing, the Ministry of Internal Affairs reported an increase of people complaining against labor exporting companies confiscating their passports and other travel documents. Simon Mundayi, the ministry spokesperson, discloses that whereas labor companies are financing passport applications for their clients, it is wrong for them to confiscate these passports.
We have our intelligence indicating that some of these companies are using these passports to ask for contracts. And when contracts are given to them, they then again ask the girls to pay more money for the passports that they already processed.
According to Mundayi, recent findings by the Ministry of Internal Affairs indicate at least 10,000 passports are being held by various labor exporting companies. Thousands of girls are currently stuck in Arab countries after their passports were confiscated from them upon arrival to those countries.
Claiming that they are waiting for contracts to be given to them from the Middle East countries. And we have received several complaints from most of these girls especially. And a total of about 8,000 passports are being held by these labor export companies.
The Directorate of Citizenship and Immigration has urged Ugandans to make use of the e-gate machines installed at Entebbe International Airport to avoid delays.
But we have seen a big number of Ugandans who use our airport at Entebbe not embracing these services of these machines, that they have preferred queuing up at the airport, causing a lot of jam, and yet we have these machines that are deployed there. These machines are operational. These machines quicken the services of clearing, especially Ugandans.
From the Uganda Police Force, there has been an increase of gangs dealing in fake currency notes. According to police spokesperson, last week an operation was conducted in Lira District and 7 criminals arrested. These criminals target mobile money agents.
Almost every after 2 weeks, we are getting cases of people dealing in counterfeit dollars and shillings. In one of the operations in North Choga and Lira City West, we arrested a gang of 7 suspects that has been exchanging counterfeit dollars for shillings and fleecing the public in Lira.
Meanwhile, the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety is intensifying its operations on errant motorists. This week, however, emphasis will be put on vehicles without the emergency triangular reflectors, as well as crash helmets for the motorcyclists.
The shape of these emergency warning signs shall be triangle. Each side shall be at least 30 centimeters. Be made of reflective materials, be painted red, and have reflectors at each corner.
The Fika Salama extra operations were introduced to curb the increasing road carnage, which continues to claim dozens of lives every week. Last week, a total of 381 road crashes were registered, and these claimed 71 lives and left over 300 seriously injured. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.